So hello everybody, welcome to our presentation about extending PnP Modern Search. My name is Pieter Vandendriessche.
And my name is Arne Meersman.
And we are joining you from Belgium. We're working for the company Delaware, and we will guide you to through some cool stuff that we discovered while working with PnP Modern Search. So let's go. So you might all use PnP Modern Search. It's a great community provided search tool or application, but it limits a bit in what is possible of extensibility. We are limited to HTML, CSS, and handlebars. We faced some limitations for certain client work, and we searched for a solution. And there we had the PnP Modern Search extensibility, where we have customized components with logic, custom handlebars that we can create. We can have our own data source. We can have custom query modifications. And yeah, that's something that is lacking in the normal solution, but the team of PnP Modern Search has provided us with an extensibility option where we can create a custom library component in SPFx. So as a developer with SPFx development skills, we can really extend everything or almost everything. If you can dream it, you can do it. And something we will show you a very cool demo of a very simple thing, but it needed an extensibility library, custom library with extensibility to achieve it. Okay, so how can we extend the PnP Modern Search web parts? Very simple, not simple because we need to do some development, of course, but we need to create an SPFx library component, and that needs to be added to your app catalog. So I already mentioned a library component. There we need to implement an interface, more on that interface later. And that interface will also provide some methods, and we need to fill in those methods to be able to extend PnP Modern Search. Then another step, I will show you it in a screenshot in a minute. We need to register our manifest in the PnP Modern Search web parts. So we do it with our manifest ID, and then the magic happens. We develop the extension, and we can view the results in our search results web part, and even in our filters web parts, depending on what type of extension that you do. Something very important that we noticed, but also clearly documented in the documentation, is that you should not mix the SPFx versions. So your library components should be in the same version as the PnP Modern Search web part solution that you have downloaded. Okay. So to mention here, for everyone who is a bit familiar with the manifest, so here we have my company library. It's a library component, and there we take the ID of our library component, we copy it, and then on the fourth page of the PnP search results, under the button configure of extensibility configuration, we link our manifest with the PnP modern PnP search results, and then we can display everything that we have customized. Okay. Then, just as a friendly reminder, with gulp serve, we get a debug string, and we can start debugging. But of course, we need to link our web parts, but we can debug through gulp serve, and then the normal package and ship procedure is the same for this library component. We upload it to the app catalog, and then alongside with the PnP Modern Search web parts, we upload our custom library component to the site.
Right, now I'm going to show you guys what we have built. We started out on a new SharePoint page where we added a couple of news pages. We added a PnP Modern Search Results web part, and we added custom styling to it. So we created the custom cards that look like this. All of this can be done without extending PnP Modern Search. But what can be done is the thing that I'm going to add now. So we can add a like component. This is the component that we have custom built for this demo. So I add it here, I click save, and you see a like component appearing on every item. Right now, if I open this example news page, you will see that I did not like this page. If we go back and we like this page here, we open it again, you will see that I have liked it now. So we really use the SharePoint API here, and this way we can get the actual likes. We can also use a second user. So if I refresh here to show the like icon, I can also like it. So it seamlessly integrates with the different users and different people. So now you see two likes. Another thing that we developed is a custom handlebar. We developed a truncate handlebar on the title. So if I copy this and paste it here where we load the title, you will see that long titles get truncated at a length of 40. So for example, here you will see that we now have the three dots, but short titles remain the same. Just a quick reminder that everything can be found here, PnP Modern Search /extensibility. This is all the documentation that you will need to create your own custom components. So how do you start by developing this extensibility library? First of all, you start by installing the required packages. A very important package here is the PnP Modern Search extensibility package. This package will contain the classes and the interface that you need to generate this library. Furthermore, we have used React and React DOM because we wanted to use React in our project. So now we see the manifest again. Here you will find the ID, which is used to link the web parts to the PnP search results web part that already exists. This needs to be of component type library. And then the starting point of our project is the My Custom Library component. And this component needs to implement this important interface, the iExtensibility library. This library this can be imported from the PnP Modern Search Extensibility package. And once you have implemented this iExtensibility library, you can start creating your own custom handlebars or your own custom components. So this is how you create your own custom web component. You use the get custom web components function, and there you can define all custom components that you want. So for example, here in the second code snippet, you can see that this is the way how we added the like component. We have the component name there, which is like component. And this is also how it's being used in our HTML. You can just use like component, like you can see in the code snippet above. The data item is basically the property which is going to be given to the like component. It's important to note here that the attributes with the data prefix will be parsed by a method resolve attributes, and that the data prefix will be gone and will just be item. I will show you this later on. So if you implement the guest custom web part components, you only need a name and you need the component class. And in this case, it's the My Custom Like component. And this is where your whole component will be built. This get custom web parts component is a method implemented from this important interface, the iExtensibility library. So here we see the basics of the My Custom Like component. This component extends the base web component. This is also an import that you need to do from the PnP search results package. And here in the constructor, we have also defined the SharePoint HTTP client. We need to use this to interact with the likes, like you saw in the demo. And here also in the code snippet below, you will see the connected callback function. Here you see how we can resolve these props, so how we can remove the data in the start and how we use the item now and how the item is given to the like component. I will not show the actual like component because this is just React and this is just a simple like component. And here you see how we render the component, how we render it. How did we interact with the likes? We used the SharePoint API for this. We used three methods. We use the like method, the unlike method, and the get like status. The get like status provides us with the count, so how many likes the post has, and whether you liked the post or not. This was fairly easy to set up. To use this endpoint, we needed the current site URL, we needed the list ID and the item ID, but these three things were fairly easy found in the item object, which we've given to the like component. And how can you add a custom handlebar? This is also done as a method that's implemented from the iExtensibility library. This method is called register handlebar customizations. Then in this method, you can call the handlebar namespace dot register helper method. And there you need to give a name. So in our example, we gave the name truncate and the function, which is just a simple truncate function. Something that's important to note here is that asynchronous code can be executed inside custom handlebars. This is basically all that we had to show. I hope we were able to show the strength of extending PnP Modern Search and show what can be achieved by extending it.